Jersey and the United States of America. Ladies and gentlemen, it was our founding fathers in 1776 who created this wonderful nation, the United States of America. They created this nation on a strong foundation, on strong pillars of God, family, and country. It was President John F. Kennedy in 1962 who challenged the American people by saying, "Ask not what your country can do for you, but ask what you can do for your country." It was President Ronald Reagan in 1976 who talked about a shining city on a hill, the United States of America. He talked about that shining city on a hill being a beacon of light for all to be guided to the shores of life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. And in our time, in the time that you and I live in today, in a time that we can be perfect examples for our children and our grandchildren, we have a president, Donald J. Trump, who during the past 2 years has reignited that flame, that beacon of that shining city on a hill to fulfill his mission to make America great again. Today, I stand before you with my full heart, soul, and spirit to acknowledge that Indian Americans have not only stood tall and stood firm on those pillars of strength that I just shared with you, that our founding fathers gave us, but the entire Indian American community, from New York to Los Angeles, from the US-Mexican border to the Canadian-US border, have become a lightning rod that has strengthened this nation. The Indian American community has done well in strengthening the foundation and the pillars of this country. Every day of every week, of every month, of every year, in every city, in every neighborhood across this country, the Indian American community has strengthened the United States of America. Through your demonstration, and I mean a real live demonstration of serving God, of devotion to family, and promoting three most important pillars that we must never ever forget, of promoting duty, honor, and country, the Indian American community is leading the way to do what? You are leading the way to make America great again. Yeah. You are leading the way like no other group of people that I've had the pleasure of meeting before. Your elderly are leading the way. Your children are leading the way. Your mothers, your fathers, your aunts, your uncles. You are leading the way to make this a great country once again. And never forget that. The news media across this country has a lot to say about a lot of things. But I think it's about time. I think it's about time we let the world know about this lightning rod called the Indian community in America. We need to let them know that there is a community right here in the United States of America, and it's the Indian community that is taking the torch that Ronald Reagan talked about, taking the mission that Donald Trump talked about, meeting the challenge that John F. Kennedy talked about, and building this country in the Indian community on the foundations that our founding fathers talked about. Ladies and gentlemen, let's talk about what the media is not saying, but we will say here today, and I'll tell you this, that I will carry with me across this country. Do you know that in Monroe Township, New Jersey, Indian Americans have one of the fastest growth rates in the Western Hemisphere? And with that growth rate comes a beacon of light that's truly helping make this country great again. People need to know that over 72% of Indian Americans have bachelor's degrees or doctorates. They need to know that over 40% have postgraduate degrees. The median household income for Indian Americans is much higher than that of any ethnicity across this country. Households headed by Indian Americans had a median income of $107,000. Now you tell me that's not making America great again. You tell me that that's not standing on those strong pillars of God, family, and country. And how about this? How about a clear message that must be brought across the country with regard to the challenges that you have met and the accomplishments that you have made? How about Indian Americans who stood strong on the principles of our founding fathers and followed that beacon of opportunity to that shining city on the hill? How about an Indian American is the CEO of Microsoft? How about an Indian American is the Surgeon General of the United States of America? How about an Indian American is the Dean of Harvard College? How about an Indian American is the U.S. Ambassador to the United Nations? How about an Indian American is the Chairman and CEO of Google? Indian Americans are serving in the United States House of Representatives, one in the United States Senate. Ladies and gentlemen, that puts the total number of Indian Americans in Congress at 5, the largest in American history. And let me share this with you. Perhaps before our lifetime ends, we will see an Indian American as President of the United States of America. Your culture has given so much to so many. And so few have heard about it until today, because they're going to be hearing a lot about it. The list goes on and on and on. The list of Americans like you who sit here today, and I'm talking to you, Grandma, and I'm talking to you, Granddad, I'm talking to you, Aunt, I'm talking to you, Uncle, I'm talking to your mother, father, and young people. I'm talking to you about your Indian American community, which is now ours as Americans, who brought the strength and heritage of your greatness to this land, to the land of the free and the home of the brave, to make America great again, so that all Americans in the years to come can say that we, that's you and me, all of us sitting here today and all of us, the Indian Americans not here, so that we in our time did the best we could to make America great again, so that our children and our grandchildren in their time can keep America great. I am proud. I am proud to stand shoulder to shoulder with you, my fellow Americans, on that shining city on a hill. And together, you can be sure, we are going to make America again. Thank you. God bless you. God bless the United States of America. And God bless the nation of India.
Stephen, thank you so much. It was really very inspirational. Thank you so much. I would like to just take note of presence of Mindy Papetti. She's the vice chair of America Winning Coalition. Michelle Albergo, chairperson, New Jersey. And Joseph Albergo, who is the Chief Communication Director of America Winning Coalition. Thank you so much, Sunil Bhai. This was a great opportunity, and we thank you so much for organizing this wonderful event. Thank you so much, Sunil Bhai.
My name is Hemant Bhatt. I am the Director, Immigration Relations of America Winning Coalition. And I have Mr. Stephen Rogers besides me, who is the president of America Winning Coalition and member of President Donald J. Trump Advisory Board 2020. I have Sunil Bhai Nayak, who is a good friend of mine and who is the mentor, who is the person who has put up this event and put up all together. I have Ilyas with me.
Yes, we have ITV Gold 24/7 TV channel, and we have 4 newspapers in from North America we are publishing, and we are proud sponsor of this event.
Okay, how do you stay up, Stephen? This is like one of the TV channels. We have gone and given the interview, ITV Gold. Mm-hmm. You know, there's Ashok Vyas took us the interview in the New York.
Yes, yes.
So these are the same people. And what do you think about this event? And how do you think that we can bridge the gap between Indian Americans and Americans?
Well, to begin with, this is one of the most magnificent events that I have ever come to. Learned a lot about your culture, your history. Boy, what a rich history that you shared with me today. And you know, Hamid asked about how do we bridge the gap. we've already started. You've done it here. By what you're doing, sharing your culture, your history, sharing the magnificent contributions that you've made to this country. You know, President Trump has talked about making America great again, and he says that from his heart. Right here in New Jersey, right here today in this organization, we're seeing living proof of the Indian American community making America great again. So we started it, and we're not going to end it. We're going ahead. We're moving forward.
Of course. And once you have come here, and you must have been now aware about what Indian culture is about, and we also are most patriotic and conservative people back home. And whatever we are doing here is very religious. We are cultured people, and we are not liberals, by the way. And we are conservative people, and we believe in what the Republicans and Mr. Trump is believing in.
Well, you know, you believe in God and country, duty, honor, and country. What I see here, look, one of the little children came up to me with great honor and respect from a little kid came up to me and shook my hand and hugged me. You don't get that in a lot of places, but I got it here. You know, I got it here, which is a tribute to the work you're doing. God, family, and country. It's all here. And I want to thank you, Mr. President. I want to thank you for that. It's been a pleasure.
Okay, Sunil Bhai, do you like to have two words, please?
Well, it's an honor and a privilege to have Mr. Stephen Rogers here. He spared his valuable time to come, not only inspired by his wonderful speech, but also visited all the exhibition areas and the very generous words that he just mentioned to not just ITV, but many other TV channels also, of how rich the Indian heritage is. So as much respect as we are getting, as much liberty as we are getting in America, we should take and be proud of the country that we live in, that country that has given us bread and butter, to go back in India and have and create the same respect for America also in India.
Thank you. So that's a very kind word, Sunil Bhai, and this guy is the person who has put up everything in this hall what you see today within very short notice, and I really appreciate that he is bringing all Indian Americans together and giving a nice platform and opportunity to see and witness the Indian culture, religion, and civilization.
I have a question. Now, is it true that you're auditioning for a job with ITV? Because he has done a terrific job.
I know. I mean, most of the time I'm like a very spoken man, and so my skills is coming here, and I'm trying to play it. Thank you.